If you're looking to be the coolest out on the highway or cruising the streets, then meet the Scorpion Covert-X to help fill that hole in your heart. We'll be taking a closer look at it in our review and road test to see how it performs. Hey everyone, I'm Sabrina from Champion Helmets and welcome back to our channel where we give in-depth reviews of the latest helmets and provide you with data-driven road tests. With the Scorpion Covert-X, the US manufacturer Scorpion has definitely managed to set it up in style. And this is saying something nice since they already raised that bar pretty high with the Scorpion Exo Combat and the Scorpion Covert. While Scorpion have also released the new Covert-X helmet as a new entry-level option in the Covert line, the two helmets are still very similar, being directly related to each other. That's why we've gone with reviewing the Covert-X today to see if it can take that Scorpion coolness level and dial it up to 11. This helmet has a recommended retail price of about 280 euros or about $300 US. At this price point, this helmet will compete with the Shark Street Drag, the Shark S-Drag 2, and the Caber Ghost Carbon. Just a quick reminder here, if you'd like to learn more about the different types of open face helmets, please feel free to subscribe and check out the rest of our YouTube channel for plenty more reviews and guides. Starting off with material, the Covert-X outer shell is made of multi-layer TCT ultra shell material, which is a combination of fiberglass, aramid, and polyresin to reduce both weight and increase the strength of the helmet. This helmet also comes in two shell sizes, which is pretty standard for this end of the open face helmet market. The Covert-X also uses a double D ring chin strap and will give you an intermediate oval head shape. Lastly, this helmet does deliver on its outer shell promise, since it comes in weighing at about 1,220 grams in a size L with all the attachments on. For ventilation, the Covert-X comes with two adjustable vents on either side of the crown that you can open with the two tabs. They are a bit small, but since this is a jet helmet, you can still expect to get air in through the chin area of the helmet. With a face mask on, you'll get plenty of ventilation through the ventilation holes in the mask, which have been covered with a fine mesh to keep debris out. The Covert-X features have pretty much the same features in terms of the helmet's visor to its predecessor, the Exo Combat. So it's a replaceable flip-down visor with tabs on either side, and it has an anti-fog coating on it. And if you want to look even cooler in this helmet, an additional dark smoke visor also comes in the box, which we always love to see. If you want to remove the mask, you just click the two buttons on either side, which makes the process very simple. Also, in the American version of the helmet, you can also remove the neck cover of the helmet to turn it into a half helmet. The liner of the Covert-X is Scorpion's Quick Wick liner, which is removable, washable, and moisture wicking. The helmet uses a micrometric buckle, which has now been padded for a bit of extra comfort. Another nice update is that this helmet has also been prepared for a communication system. To remove the liner, the cheek pads are attached with some Velcro and an additional button. The material feels comfortable, though a little basic. To remove the comfort liner, you've got two buttons on the back and four head snaps at the front. Again, the liner is a little Spartan, but it does have some holes in it to help with ventilation. Looking at the EPS grooves, you can also see that there are quite a lot, so you should be able to get a nice amount of ventilation in this helmet, which we will find out in the road test later. The build quality could have been a bit higher since there were a few bits of leftover glue still floating around. The EPS liner wasn't uniformly painted. Maybe it's just me nitpicking, but Scorpion, if you're listening, please feel free to improve this. Now, let's see whether this helmet's performance can match up to its looks out on the road. If you're not familiar with our road test setup, let me quickly take you through it. On the left, we have a white monitor showing the helmet's internal temperature in degrees Celsius, measured through a thermometer in the helmet's EPS channels. In the middle is our decibel meter taking noise readings from a microphone placed near our rider's ear. On the right, we have a phone that's showing the airspeed for the day through a bike-mounted anemometer. Lastly, in the middle on the dash is our rider's speed and the day's external temperature. When we tested the Covert-X out, the weather was pretty decent, with some sunshine and a temperature of 18 degrees Celsius. The wind speed was also pretty consistent, between 115 to 130 kilometers per hour, and our rider is riding with a constant speed of 130 kilometers on his bike. For the ventilation, we got a consistent reading of 17 degrees inside of the helmet, meaning that there is only 1 degree difference from outside of the helmet, which is quite a great result. Next, the noise averaged out to 108 decibels, which was disappointing as it is very noisy inside the helmet. Sure, it will be a lot less riding around town, where this helmet is worn most of the time anyway. But if you're planning to do longer stretches of the highway, you really shouldn't forget your earplugs. With regards to comfort, our rider said it basically did what he expected from it. He said it was pretty average, but slightly better when compared to the Scorpion Exo Combat Evo, as it has a better ventilation and is slightly quieter. He loved the concept of the helmet and said it is a helmet that is so cool looking that you would buy it just for that. It's not a helmet for going longer trips that will give you that high-end touring comfort. But nonetheless, for riding around town, it offers a lot more than many of its competitors. He found the chin part sturdy as he couldn't feel any wind drag or movement in the two major parts while riding in the helmet. So far the road test. If you have any questions for our test rider, write them down in the comments and he will try to answer all of them. Now let's see how well the Covert-X really scored. The shell of the Covert-X is a glass fiber and came in two shell sizes, which earns the helmet 3 stars in the material category. As for the weight, the helmet is pretty light with 1220 grams, earning it another 4 stars. The visor to this helmet is pretty average, earning it 2 stars in this category. The noise isolation on this helmet was very poor since we recorded a loud 108 decibels, so it only scored a disappointing 1 star for that. However, this helmet ventilated very well with just 1 degree difference, earning it an excellent 5 stars. Lastly, the Covert-X was pretty standard in terms of comfort, earning it 2.5 stars. To sum it up, this gives the Covert-X an average of 2.7 stars and with a recommended retail price of 280 euros or $320, that gives this helmet 14.7 euros per star. We tested the Scorpion Covert-X on the same as its direct competitors. When we weighed in all the scores, compared it to its current competitors and did the math, we learned that the Scorpion Covert-X scores a rank number 2 on our Champion Helmets ranking. If you'd like to purchase the Scorpion Covert-X, make sure to head to Champion Helmets where we have a lowest price guarantee and plenty of bundle deals including a free additional visor. Unsurprisingly, the Covert-X is going for looks over practicality and comfort, though it is useful to have the multiple configurations and there have definitely been improvements, it's clear that this is still the main focus of the helmet. If you liked the video, make sure to subscribe, leave us a like, and let us know what you think in the comments down below. Would this helmet style be something for you? I'm Sabrina from Champion Helmets. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.